Most areas along the borderline have since the 16th of June 2023 faced a number of attacks by ADF rebels, with the most recent one being an attack on a tourist van in Queen Elizabeth National Park. Due to these attacks, the government beefed up security in areas around the border. In his current security update, the president of Uganda, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, has revealed on his X platform that UPDF attacked an ADF camp. This is to inform you that today, the 21st of October 2023, we paid a serious visit to the ADF terrorists in Congo. Our gunships attacked a big camp of these criminals 60 kilometers from the border, Ntoroko side. The attack was devastating because it was a clear target and the reconnaissance plane was monitoring from the air. Congratulations to our Air Force and the SDR that locates these criminals, the president wrote on his Twitter. Meanwhile, the group of five people that burnt the lorry, the tourist van, and killed two tourists and their driver is being hunted in the areas of Bwera, Chikokorongo Road, as you come to Bwera. The president added that the UPDF should involve the police and the Wanainchi to hunt for these groups running from Congo. They are no longer a military problem. They are police, popular vigilance, and anti-terrorism efforts. We are destroying their base in Congo. We salute His Excellency Tshisekedi for agreeing to work with us to uproot these criminals. Relatedly, people and the local leaders in communities along the borderline have also highly embraced the aspect of vigilance. The G8, which is a combination of 8 lower local governments, have also done a lot to ensure the safety of their people. These have highlighted challenges that hinder their security operations.
That most of us, most of the local leaders, have not undergone any refresher course or any military training that can help them or equip them with the tactics and the knowledge of how they can respond or what we can tell our people when we are attacked.
That we have talked to heaven and us about them, so we'll be the next target, but we don't fear. We decided to work for the people, with the people. If they come, we'll see also how we defend ourselves.
While giving an update on the security status in Katwe, Kabatoro Town Council, covering part of Queen Elizabeth National Park, where the tourists were killed, John Bosco Kananura, the LC3 chairperson, revealed that the security of the area has been tightened.
We have heightened security measures. We have what I can call the best deployment by the army and the police.
On his part during the meeting with the local leaders, Godfrey Kabianga, the state minister for ICT and national guidance, ordered chiefs and town clerks to include funding needed for security during their budget allocations.
Congregate chiefs should look for some funding now, such that the LOC ones should congregate every quarter to discuss security. The chairman of the LOC should be facilitated to call security meetings, LOC ones, so that they give a report of their area.
Report compiled by Samuel Amanyire for the news.